Welcome to Kraos BI. I'm Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be going through the data visualization guide on AI visuals. Before we get started on that, let's dig into what are these AI visuals. AI visuals allow us to leverage the work our data science friends have done amongst all of the analytics that we're doing, right? We can drag, drop, add these features and these visuals in, and we can gain deeper, richer understanding of the information that's going on. When you roll these out to the end users, make sure you do this in a way that's either exceedingly clear to them how it should work and operate naturally inside the experience, and that's ideal. But if you need to train some people on like how to use one of these visuals, how to go into it, plan that out. Plan to include little videos like this on how you use a decomposition tree or how you can use the, you know, the Q&A, right? These trainings, these tips can really help with your adoption of these resources. These look like magic. They're not, you know, this data and the visualizations that come out of it don't look like they could be real to most people when they come and look at it. It is the next step into the next generation. This is a leap, quantum leap forward when it comes to analytics. And we need to find ways that we could take advantage of these right now and make sure that these insights are not just being trapped and locked away with analysts, but they're getting out in the hands of our executives, in the hands of our frontline workers, in the hands of our business, in the hands of our sales force, so that we can help them understand the data better. All right, let's head over to the style guide. On the data style guide, let's click on into our AI. Now, two big ones that we have here, the smart narrative that we've talked about already, super easy to add in. All you do is build out your report, click on smart narrative, voila. You want to go into customization on this, you could do tons of customization in here. The decomposition tree is straight up, this is one of the greatest things that's out here when it comes to identifying root cause of why sales are going up or sales are going down. Make sure you spend some time in building this out. You can really take people on a journey with this visual as long as you've put some thought into this. Work with your business partners to make sure you're including all of the appropriate breakdowns that are relevant to the users as they go into understanding this. The key will be looking for what are those action points that users can take and making sure that you focus in on those. I have these in the secondary category, but frankly, only because I've been following this pattern for all these other visuals. These are fire. These are incredible visuals that are out there as part of the service. The Q&A functionality is out of this world. Please go out and check this out. They rolled this out a few years ago and it went, eh. The new configuration that you can do is great. This line chart with anomaly detection, this too is a preview feature. Make sure you go to File, Options and Settings, Options, Preview Features, and you turn on anomaly detection. This is super useful for you. Basically, you on any line chart, you go over to your what the heck is this thing called? Analytics button. Go down to find anomalies, turn it on. You can set your sensitivity threshold. You can then create your explain bys so that when a user comes in and they see like these anomalies that have been generated, all they do is click on it. Up pops another sidebar with a graph that highlights, shows where it is. Allows them to see what is driving that information. Just frankly, this is mind-blowing stuff. Just absolutely love this. And then the key influencers graph. This is a big one that you can look to use to bring into and share with people. Now I have this filtered for visual purposes, but you know, you can put a lot into this, the key influencers chart, spend some time with it. This is an awesome addition to your report. Because these have interactions with them, They do not work good as pop-ups, but the smart narrative does, right? Because you don't have to interact with it. You can have it pop up. Users can read it, and then they can move on, all right? So these AI visuals are truly the next step in analytics. They really bring that power to Power BI. I am super stoked to run people through these. Every time I get the opportunity to add them into a report, I definitively do. In fact, sometimes I create additional pages in my report to just hone in on this, you know, merely to educate users that these are things that are possible, right? Because we want to introduce these concepts and these ideas to the people that are working our business so that they can come back to us and say, hey, Chris, I've got this really big problem in accounting. We're trying to understand blah, blah, blah. I was looking at your video and I saw this other report that had a decomposition tree in it. Well, root cause analysis of, you know, our issue would be incredibly valuable. Do you think you could add in? I mean, I know you're going to be busy and I know we built out that data set, but I don't know how hard it is. Could you add it in the decomposition tree? And to which I say, of course. And then I add it in and they go, wow, that's magic, right? So YouTube can do magic for your users using all of these resources that are just part of the tool. Do please play with them, check them out, learn how to use them. Let me know down below if you have any questions. Leave those questions down below and I'm happy to answer them. We can start to build our community. Hopefully we can all start to go back and forth. But thank you guys very much. If you like this content, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and turn on the alarm bell to get notifications for every time I post a video. Thank you guys very much. Peace.